Hello everybody and welcome to this new video. And today we are going to talk about how to get that great Gretsch tone. And over here I have my Gretsch guitar. It's a G5120. And well, as the name might suggest, it is the cheaper built brother of the 6120. This one has been made in Korea and I bought it in like the mid-2000s. During the mid-2000s, I don't know the exact year, Gretsch started with the Electromatic series, and I don't know the full details, so please correct me if I'm wrong. But they started the series with like the orange G5120 because it was an anniversary model and they also wanted to try a cheaper model. And then there came a second batch and that one also came in different colors. And this one is from the second batch because yeah, the 5120s sold really well. So Gretsch was like, yeah, okay, we're gonna try a cheaper lineup. And that became the Electromatic line. And this one is built in Korea. And just something to clear it up. A lot of people think that all the expensive Gretsches are built in America, but most of them are built in Japan. And then the Electromatic series are built in different factories all around Asia, I believe also Indonesia and China. But this one was still built in Korea, and I really, really love the sound of this guitar. And for the expert, for the eagle eyes, some will say like, yeah, you've got a different pickguard because the original second line of the G5120s had a translucent pickguard. And yes, I know, but I liked this more silverish one, so I replaced it. I think it looks way better than the translucent version. So first, let's talk about the controls on the guitar, because I think for a lot of players at start, they can be a little bit difficult to understand, and they're a little bit different from what you might expect from like the Gibson guitars. Well, first of all, you got your pickup selector, and yes, it's a pickup selector. It selects the pickups, bridge, boat, and the neck pickup. And I must say, this is the weak part of this guitar. Sometimes it just fails and you have to wiggle out a bit and then it works again. So yeah, still have to replace it, but everybody who knows hollow body guitars, you have to go through the air holes and stuff and you don't have a lot of room to do it. So I'm still found myself willing to do this. Okay, then go to the other controls. At first over here, we've got a master volume. So when I turn it up, or down, and now go to like the, and here you see, or the middle position, it does it for both the pickups. Now over here in the back, we've got a tone knob and two volume knobs. This volume is for the neck pickup and this volume is for the bridge pickup. And then the last control, if you can call it controlling, is the Bixby. So now let's play around with the sounds. And just for your information, at the back I've got my Fender Blues Deluxe reissue. I've got it on the drive channel. At this moment there is no reverb on it. Put it a little bit higher than I would normally do, because with a Gretsch, a little bit reverb can be great. And I will make a shot of all the settings so you can see how I set it up. And yes, these things can get loud. Let's first start with like a rock tone, because when you see these guitars, maybe you won't expect any rock tones, but I believe Neil Young and stuff rocked on it, and Pete Townshend, so. And take Brian Setzer, all of more rock and roll, but yeah, just a nice dirty tone. Bridge pickup, volume full up, and just love it. Then, if you want a more cleaner sound, the most simple thing you can do is just turn down your main volume. And it cleans up really well. And shall I do this? Well, I can. If you like the 60s and all the guitar sounds from that era, you can't go wrong with this guitar. But maybe, hey, you're more of a jazz guy. Well, just go to the bridge pickup. And now, if you want to have a little bit less top end in it, turn down the tone up. Now you lose a bit of volume, so let's open the volume a little bit, the main volume. Yes, it's a nice sweet sound. Maybe a little bit B.B. King is. It's a really nice and yeah, sweet round tone. Now there's another trick. If you go to the middle section, but if you're like, yeah, I like this sound, but it's a little bit too bright. Then you can go over here and just turn down the bridge pickup a little bit. Also open the main tone. You can really custom dial in the way you want the blend of the two pickups. I'll first do main, roll off the high end a bit, roll off a little bit of the neck, winds up. Don't go too low because then the guitar dies, you need to have them open both. But now please keep in mind that when you go back to the neck pickup, it's still on the lower volume. But you can use this again in a very nice way, because you can go from like this more rockish tone, and you switch up and you got this. So you can really play around with this really easily. And now, since we are looking to like 60 sound, if I put a little bit of slap echo on it, you have all your nice rockabilly country tones. Just turn off the pedals and turn on the reverb. And let's have a talk about the Bixby. Bixby's, I love them just to give this little bit of a nice wobble. Maybe not too much, but we all know this part. Now let's put an echo in, but now on slightly longer. And yes, now I'm probably more an acoustic player than an electric player, but yeah, these guitars really bridge the gap for me. Now unfortunately for everybody who is like, I want to have that guitar, these ones aren't built anymore. But in the links down below, I put some. And now for everybody who is like, I want to have the guitar too. Unfortunately, these aren't sold or made anymore. Maybe they are still sold somewhere, but they aren't made anymore. But in the description down below, I've put down some links to other types of electromagnetic guitars in the same budget range, which I would advise, which I tried in the stores the past months. And yes, maybe some people will look at the electromagnetic line like, yeah, they are cheap and they are Asian built. Like I thought in the first part of the video, most of the Gretsch guitars are built in Asia nowadays. And yes, they may be cheaper, but you can't go wrong with these guitars in my humble opinion. So I hope you like this video. And if you own a Gretsch yourself, please tell me below which one you have and why you like it. And if you've got any tips or advice on Gretsch and for other users, please drop it below. I always love to read your stories. And if you're not subscribed yet to my channel, please click down below on subscribe. Give this video a thumbs up, or you can click here or here for videos that I've made in the past or down below or something. And hope to see you soon with the next video. Bye bye. Let's do a little bit of an outro tune.